And so, even the Bible tells us that people that teach others to justify, teach others to disobey God's commandments, you know, they will receive their reward. Well, God blesses those people that teach others to obey all of His commandments, because all of His commandments are of equal importance. So, just because you obey one, if you just obey only the Sabbath and you don't obey others, you're deceiving yourself. Because to obey one, to disobey one is to disobey all. So we have to keep each and every one. They are all important. And I also want to talk about how to get saved. The Bible gives us specific instructions on how to get saved. Romans 10:9-10. Tells us that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. You see that? If thou shalt confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So, it does not say, if thou shall turn away from your sin first, or if thou shalt be baptized first. All those things, they are not requirements. The only thing that God has said you need to do in order to be saved is belief. Believe. Verse 10 says, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. And Hebrews tells us that our faith is accounted to us for righteousness. Romans 3:22-24. Romans 3:22-24.
Even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ, unto all and upon all them that believe, for there is no difference. Verse 23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. John 3:16 tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only beloved Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish but have eternal life. Acts 16:30-31. And brought them out, saying, sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, they being Paul and Silas. And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. The reason why, and there's so many other passages, you know, Ephesians 2:8-9, and so many other passages, that clearly show that it's by believing on Jesus Christ. That is faith, because faith is another word for belief. By our faith, we are saved. Because it's not by any works we can do. It's not by turning away from your sins or doing anything that you are saved. It is by your faith in Jesus Christ that you are saved. The Bible is very clear on that. But after you are saved, you repent of your sins. Because you now have the grace of God. You are saved by the grace of God because of your faith. Through faith, we are saved by grace through faith. So once we are saved by faith and receive the grace of God, it is because of that grace of God we are now able to repent. Repentance is turning away from our sins. We forsake all our sins and we don't go back to them. But because we are humans and every now and again we still stumble, you know, we still break one or two commandments, still commit this and that sin. We have to keep on repenting. It's a continuous process. So we have every day in prayer, we have to keep on repenting. You know, when we speak to God and asking Him to cleanse us and to forgive us of our sins, you know, the ones we commit every day. But the sin that was going to cause us eternal death has been forgiven, because God has given us eternal life through Jesus Christ. So we are not spiritually clean, and we have to maintain that spiritual cleanness by confessing our sins, repenting of our sins every day, and by reading the Word, because the Word of God washes us spiritually. You know, Jesus is the water of life, and He's the Word of God. So when you read the Word of God, it is not the letters that cleanse you, it's the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit that cleanses you spiritually. Jesus Christ. So, the reason why I want to emphasize faith is because a lot of people preach that once you believe, once you have faith, you have to be baptized, you have to do this, you have to... Baptism is not a requirement. Yes, I said it. The disciples baptized, the apostles baptized, and everything. Jesus himself did not baptize. And Jesus himself has made it clear that baptism of the Holy Ghost is what he gives us. Baptism of water is just a sign, it's a symbol, a profession of faith. It is not a necessity. If you choose to profess your faith to the public, you know, to your brethren or to whomever, that is what you do. You get baptized, you know. But it's a personal thing. If you want people to see that, you know, I am with Jesus and everything. But it is not a necessity. 1 Corinthians 1:17, Paul says, "For Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect." And the people that emphasize baptism are making the cross of Christ of none effect, because that is the same thing the Jews did. They were emphasizing circumcision. You know, when Paul was preaching to the Gentiles, they were emphasizing circumcision, and they were telling the Gentiles that no, that they are not saved, that even though they believed on Jesus, they are still not saved because they were not circumcised. And circumcision was an outward profession that the Jews belonged to God, that they were children of God. You see, that was how they separated themselves. It was outward profession. They had to circumcise their son. So the Jews were not telling the Gentiles that they were not saved, they were not truly saved, and they were not truly children of God because they were not circumcised like they were. And Paul and some other disciples of Christ rebuked those Jews for doing that, because they were making the cross of Christ of none effect. You see, once Jesus died, all this outward appearance, it wasn't necessary, because we entered into a new covenant, a better covenant. And now, the circumcision is of the heart. It's no longer a physical circumcision, but of a spiritual